one previous video, you learned how to install DHCP server. In this video, we're going to create scopes. Let's start. Before starting to create scopes, let's take a look at our client's IP configuration. You have two options. You can either use command prompt or use Windows interface. Let's start by looking at the command prompt. From your start menu, search for command prompt and open it. Inside your command prompt, type ipconfig. This tool shows you a summary of your IP configuration. In this example, on my lab computer, you can notice that the client has 169.254.193.176 as the client IP address. We know that this range is APIPA. APIPA or APIPA is automatic private IP addressing. What is this range? When the client is set to receive IP from the DHCP server, if for any reason client cannot communicate with the DHCP server or if the DHCP server is not available, then Windows will automatically assign a random IP address from this range. This is called the automatic private IP addressing. This tool will become your number one troubleshooting tool when it comes to the IP address issues. By typing ipconfig/all, system will show you more details about your IP configuration. You can see if the system has a static IP or if it is set to receive the IP from DHCP. You can check the physical or MAC address of your computer. Check your IP configuration and IP address, DNS settings, and many more. We will look into more of these settings later. In order to check your computer IP setting using the GUI, open the network connection page by typing ncpa.cpl in run command. Press Windows key and R to open run and type ncpa.cpl. From the network connection page, right-click on your network adapter and select properties. Select IPv4 and click properties. In this window, you can see your client is set to obtain an IP address from DHCP. Also, on the alternate configuration page, you can see the desired behavior for when the DHCP is not available. The default behavior for alternate IP configuration is to use APIPA or automatic private IP addresses. If you want, you can change this and set an static IP address by selecting User Configured option and typing your desired IP. One use case of this scenario is, imagine one of your employees work in your office, but at home, he needs to have a static IP address. He doesn't have a router or his router does not provide IP addresses. So if he needs to connect to the internet at home, he will need to use a static IP address. And when he comes back to the company, he has to change it to automatic again. In order to change that, you can easily set the computer to receive the IP address from the DHCP and make sure that the alternate configuration is set with a static IP. With that setup, when he's in the office, he will receive the IP from the DHCP server. And when he's at home, when no DHCP is available, he will use the statically assigned IP. The other place that you can check is your network status. Right-click on your network adapter and select Status. Then click Details. In this page, you can see the currently assigned IP, how it is assigned, what is the subnet mask, gateway, and a few more options. As you notice, these are the same information that we could find with ipconfig. Now let's start configuring DHCP and start leasing IP addresses. A DHCP scope is the fundamental component of the DHCP architecture. A scope contains a pool of IP addresses, either IPv4 or IPv6, depending on which scope are we creating. DHCP does not only provide IP, you can send other options as well. By options, we mean default gateway, domain name system suffix, or maybe the DNS servers, and many more. Scopes contain the relevant pool of IP addresses and related information that is used to configure your network. On your DHCP, you can create as many pools or scopes as you want. When a client reaches out to the DHCP server and asks for an IP address, DHCP will look into its pools and decide which pool to use and which IP to lease. Then, DHCP will send back an IP address to the client selected from one of the pools. When your DHCP is serving several pools and several networks, DHCP will look at the client's network to decide which pool to use. You will learn more about DHCP Relay Agent in the future. But in general, when a client sends the request to the DHCP server, the packet will include which network does that client reside. Based on that information, the DHCP server can decide which one of the pools it should look for an IP. Let's create our DHCP scope. Log into your server and open the DHCP console. From the server manager, go to the tools menu and select DHCP. Open your server and right-click on IPv4 and select new scope. Click next on the first page. Give your scope a name and enter a description. This will help you identify your scopes easier when you have several scopes. On the next page, you will define the IP address range for your pool. Enter the starting and end IP address for your pool. In this step, you're technically telling your DHCP what is the range of IP addresses that it can use to lease IP address to clients. To select your subnet mask, you can either type the subnet mask ID or you can use the CIDR notation. On the next page, you can set exclusions and delay. Exclusion is a range that you don't want your DHCP to use when leasing an IP address from a pool. You might ask, why should we create a pool and then exclude some of that? Well, sometimes you're adding a pool to an existing environment that some other production servers have already set their IP addresses manually. If your DHCP server starts to lease IP addresses in the same range, then you will have IP conflicts on your network and it will affect some of your production servers. With the exclusion range, you can separate a range of IP addresses and make sure that your DHCP will not use those IP or that range of IP addresses. You can also instruct your DHCP to wait a few milliseconds before leasing the IP. This can be very useful when you have several DHCP servers serving the same IP range. We will cover this subject in more details in future videos. Enter your exclusion range, hit Add, and click Next. On the next page, you can set your lease period. This is the time that identifies how long a client can hold on to the same IP. The best practice is to set it to longer periods for environments that you do not have moving devices or you do not have too many guests. Imagine a library. During the day, many users might come in, join the network, do their job, get an IP address from the DHCP server, and leave after a few hours. If you set the lease period to 8 days, then DHCP will not be able to use the IP address for 8 days, and your scope will run out of IP addresses very quick. But if you set the lease duration to some smaller numbers, maybe 2 hours, DHCP can lease the IP address to a new user. The user has to renew the IP address if the user stays more than 2 hours and can hold on to the IP address as long as they are there. But once they leave the environment, the DHCP can check if the IP has not been used and if it has not been renewed, then it can release it and offer the same IP to another user. Now, if you have a network with physical computers connected to your network with few changes, you can set the time to 8, 10, or maybe 15 days. This will reduce the DHCP traffic on your network. Set your desired time and click Next. On the next page, Wizard will ask you if you want to select and configure any options. An IP address and subnet mask are the minimum settings needed for a computer to communicate with a network. But we know almost every network requires a DNS server IP address for name resolution and a default gateway to communicate with other subnets or internet. You can configure your DHCP server to send both of these IP addresses to the clients when they lease an IP. We will talk about the options in more details in future videos. You can always come back and change your scope options later. For now, select Yes to add a few options. First, type in the IP address of the default gateway you would like to use and click Next. On the domain name and DNS server, you will notice that the system has automatically entered the domain name and the DNS server IP addresses. The reason is that this DHCP server is authorized in a domain environment and it knows the domain name and the IP address of the DNS server. If you want, you can add as many DNS servers as you need. Enter your information and click Next. On the next page, if you need, you can add your WINS server. WINS is a service that translates net BIOS names to IP addresses. On the last step, you can decide if you would like to activate the scope or keep it deactivated. You can always come back to activate or deactivate the scope. If you don't activate your scope, DHCP will not be able to lease any IP address from that scope. Click Next and Finish. You now have created your first scope. By right-clicking on your scope, you can see the name, start and end IP address, lease duration, and the description of your scope. You also notice there are two more tabs called DNS and Advanced, which we will cover later. If you click on Address Lease, you will see the list of clients who have leased an IP address from the DHCP server. Also, selecting the scope option shows you the list of options you decided during the scope creation. You can also notice that there are two sets of options available: options at the server and options at the scope level. We will cover the options in more detail. Now that we have a DHCP server on the network, let's go back to our client and see what is the IP status of that client right now. From your client computer, go to the Start menu, search for CMD, and open command prompt. Type ipconfig, and now you can see your client has a new IP address from the range you defined for your scope. You can also notice the connection suffix is set to your domain name, and also a default gateway has been set. Type ipconfig/all to see more detailed information. You can see client is set to receive IP from DHCP. You can even see the IP address of the DHCP who leased the IP address. This is the same IP address that the client will use to communicate to when it needs to renew the IP. You can also see when the IP was leased and when will it expire. You can see all this information from network connections page as well. Press Windows and R. This will open run. Type ncpa.cpl to open the network connection page. The first thing that you notice is that your domain name suffix is added to the network adapter card. If you look at the properties of the card, you can see it is set to receive the IP address from DHCP. And if you open the status page, you can see all the information again. As your final checks, if you open your DHCP console again and go to the address list, you will see one entry has been added. This means one client has already leased an IP address from this DHCP scope. You can create scopes with PowerShell as well. In this section, I will show you how to create scopes using PowerShell. I will also make sure to show you how to find the commands that you need, even if you don't know how to use them. From your server, open PowerShell as administrator. Type get -command *DHCP server*. This will show a list of all PowerShell commandlets that have the word DHCP server in them. You can see there are quite a lot of commands with DHCP server in them. And if you pay a little bit more attention, you will notice they are categorized in four sections. In PowerShell, commands have two sections, a verb and a noun. Verbs like get, set, remove, add, install, and many more. For DHCP, you will notice you have commands with add, get, remove, and set. There are also a few more verbs like backup, restore, import, and export. We will talk about those in future videos. Now, quickly scroll through the commands to see some available options. Let's try getting the list of our existing scopes. Type get -DHCP server v4 scope. This will list all IPv4 scopes. You can see scope ID, subnet mask, name, state, start and end range, and the lease duration. If you like to learn how to use a specific command, you can ask PowerShell to help you. Simply type get -help and then the name of the command which you would like to learn. Example, get -help add -DHCP server v4 scope. PowerShell will prompt you to download the updated version of the help. If your system has access to the internet, select yes to get more detailed guidelines. I will select no for this demo. System will show you the syntax of the command and the parameters that needs to be added. Let's try adding a scope. Type add -DHCP server v4 scope -start range. Enter your start range for your scope. -end range, the last IP address of your range. -subnet mask, enter your subnet mask. -name, give your scope a name. And -description, make sure to put both name and description in quotes. Lastly, you need to type in -state active to make sure that your scope is activated. Hit enter. Now, if you get the list of the scopes with PowerShell again, you can see that you have two scopes. You can check from the DHCP console as well. Open DHCP console and click on IPv4. You will see your new scope is created and does not have any options yet. That's how you create a scope with PowerShell. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Join me on the next videos to learn how to create super scopes, reservations, learn a deeper knowledge on scope options, learn how to provide high availability to your DHCP server, and many more. See you on the next videos.